Pasito tum tum, pasito tum tum, pasito tum tum.
When it comes to making a video analysis, it can take a while, but it's simple enough. You watch the film as many times to understand it, you do your research, you check a few behind the scenes, you check the context of when it was made and what is the story, regardless of how long it can take. Persona and Mulholland Drive, they're different. To sum up these two films, it's like what an old pirate once said.
Reason's got nothing to do with it.
These are films that demand us to put our logical research away and explore it through our subconsciousness. They're port gates that open up our minds in what lies beneath our most deepest, darkest of our fantasies. Now, these are not easy movies to analyze on the first viewing. It's a case scenario where you realize you're not in Kansas anymore, but in the rabbit hole where the twisted and the illusion dictate what makes sense and where insanity is normal. So before I forget who I am, I just need to ask the weird question. Persona, Mulholland Drive. What did they have in common? Surrealist dream! To get inside the mind of the film, we should get inside the mind of the directors. Ingmar Bergman, the director of Persona, and AB Lynch, the director of Mulholland Drive. Even though I'm not a big fan of Bergman or Lynch, both have been considered as great filmmakers. Their movies have earned a rap of being arthouse films because they explore the human psyche through dreams as Bergman and surrealism as Lynch, often showing a different personality in the dream but being someone else in reality.
Du är en gammal egoist, farbror Isak. Men du maskerar det bra bakom din gammelmans finess, din vänliga charm.
They combine the illusions of dream with reality, oftentimes turning into nightmares crossing our reality. In that way, they almost feel like art, but it's not the type of art that descends us into forgetting reality, but to come into terms with it. With Bergman, it can be accepting our inability to escape dead in the Seventh Seal, or appreciate the present even if the past was better in Wild Strawberries. Some may see Bergman's films as dark, but his illusion has more optimistic intentions. The images are expressed poetically to make something ugly turn into something beautiful. David Lynch is more pessimistic in the dreams, showing us that life can not only be bad, it can be really ugly. Lynch's use of surrealism goes way back to his early studies as a painter, which he still does to this day. His films, along with Bergman, could be commercially successful, but they were made to be surreal paintings that could move and submerge us to the subconsciousness macabre of life, showing the struggle of a father taking care of a deformed child in Eraserhead, or Joseph Merrick being a deformed outcast in The Elephant Man, or even experience the Hollywood disillusion in Mulholland Drive. Man, this is my third video in a row I make about how Hollywood can suck. Even though Mulholland is not a remake to Persona, it feels like a remake. Both open up with a surreal collection of scenes depicting how jumbled and weird it would get, but in Persona it is much more twisted. Both stories focus on two women, one that is sick and one that takes care of the sick one. One is an actress, though in Persona the actress is the one that's sick, and in Mulholland Drive the one that seems healthy is the actress. There's some lesbian tension between the two of them, but as we get to know them more, we start noticing how similar the helper is to her ill partner. Almost too similar, as if the helper is her ill partner. Now the thing with these movies is, they're not easy to understand. They're too surreal and symbolic to get what just happened in the first viewing. Lynch was notorious for not revealing what his movies meant. He always left it to open interpretation so that we, the viewer, could come up with the meaning, just like a painting. So as Bergman would dialogue his movies like poetry so we could read the human emotions in it. Together, they are a coalition of poetry and surreal art mashing a collection of open thoughts and interpretations. They make us think and solve the mystery for ourselves. Whatever interpretation we come up with doesn't mean that it's wrong if it doesn't line up with majority opinion. It's not what others see in the painting, it's what your mind sees in the painting. Their meanings cannot be reasoned through reading or searching in a book. It can be only understood by our intuition, putting all the pieces that we saw in words and say them as how they come out, even if it doesn't always make sense. So, what are Persona and Mulholland Drive about? They're about our denial, our confusion, and our acceptance of our individuality and our sins. In Persona, a nurse named Alma takes care of Elizabeth, an actress who had a mental breakdown and turned mute. Elizabeth has a backstory of abandoning her son to an orphanage. We see the boy glance at a blurry image of two women, and it's made to believe that it could be Elizabeth, his mother. We then see Alma and Elizabeth connect more intimately and more sexually as Alma reveals her backstory of abortion. And as things get weirder, Elizabeth's husband confuses Alma to be his wife. Then it's revealed through Alma's denial that she might have been Elizabeth all along. So all this time, the orphan was looking at an image of her mother, Alma. Or was it Elizabeth? Or was it both of them? In Mulholland, an upcoming naive actress named Diane meets a strange woman named Rita who survived a car crash but suffered lost memory. After strange occurrences of a kill gone wrong, a frustrated director, a creepy nightmare gone real, we see Diane and Rita getting more sexual as everything seems to go well for Diane. But as she then discovers a blue box, she wakes up from her dream, revealing a darker, more depressing Diane whose career went nowhere. It's then revealed that Rita took away Diane's opportunity, which provoked her to get Rita killed, leading up to guilt, regret, insanity, and tragic suicide. Now, what isn't certain is whether if Elizabeth or Rita were real, or were they just an imaginative recreation. They seem too vague and mysterious to be real, but were also liars and opportunists to not be real. At the same time, they give us hints that they might be the same person.
Vad jag tänkte när jag hade varit och sett din film den där kvällen. När jag kom hem så såg jag mig i spegeln och så tänkte jag, men vi är ju lika.
Diane Selwyn. Maybe that's my name.
Another example is the repetition of scenes from different point of views. In Persona, Alma blames Elizabeth for her bad parenting, and it's all shot from Elizabeth's point of view. But then later the scene is repeated again from Alma's point of view. Was she blaming herself as a parent? Or was she creating a different persona to put all the blame on that person? In Mulholland, we first see Rita in the car crash, but then later the scene gets repeated, this time Diane being in the car. Did Rita ever get inside that car? Or did Diane imagine that Rita survived her kill? Now, what is certain is that everything happened inside Alma's and Diane's alternative dream through the use of symbolisms. In Persona, there are plenty of close-up shots where half of the faces are covered up, as if they're only half of what they seem to be, and their other half is the face of another person. In Mulholland, blue is a color that keeps popping up. A blue box, a blue key, a blue wig. Blue can represent the illusion of a dream waking up to reality. Whether if Elizabeth or Rita were real or not, it is how Alma and Diane react on not taking responsibility of their actions. For Alma, it is her way to deal with her abortion guilt by creating an image of a worse mother than her. For Diane, it is her way to deal with her failed career and how it destroyed her life. If Rita was real, then it is her way to deal with the guilt of her death. Both have an equal resistance to accept reality. For Alma, it is all just a movie where she depicts herself as the good person inside the movie. For Diane, it is all just an illusion where she's more upbeat and more optimistic. In the moment they accept reality is in the middle of Persona when the film reel burns in Diane's face as if her movie world just shattered. In Mulholland is where the magician reminds her that nothing she sees is real, and once she opens that mysterious blue box is when she returns to her dark, disillusioned reality. But even with those clues interpreted, it still feels like a loophole that keeps getting more confusing. Now, what is simple to interpret is that both stories are about taking responsibility. These characters are unable to do so, and they go too far by creating an escapism from reality. But at the end of the day, reality seems to find them in their deepest alternative worlds, because just like reality, guilt falls even deeper in our subconsciousness. Persona and Mulholland Drive can be about many things. They can be about poetry and film, about surrealism, our inner examination, the movie industry, questioning if dreams matter, the gender role of women wanting to break from tradition and make something out of their own. It can at times feel like homework, but if you love the weird, you will love this homework. And if you don't know what weird is, then heh, you don't know Lynch.
And Bergman, you don't know Bergman. Yeah, I didn't know how to fit that name in that last line, so that really made no sense. But then again, it's a realism. Not everything fits, as we assume. So, what do you thought about these movies? Were they too easy to interpret? Were they hard to interpret? What's your interpretation about them? Leave your thoughts on the comment section to see what you thought about them. And if you like this video, leave a like and subscribe for more content.
Why did you say that name?
What was that? I didn't say nothing. Oh well then. Woo! Feeling a little blue here. Let me get this out of my chest. Whoa! Tune in next time, because when I get back, I'll be reviewing the movies of this winter. Because it's little fishy. Feeling a little dizzy right now. That's it for today. Ciao.
Did I just dream about Marta?
Pasito tum tum, pasito tum tum, pasito.